From multiple luxury cars to real estate that will have your mouth gaping, Rafael Nadal has enough possessions to last at least 10 lifetimes. This tennis star is as lavish as they come, and we really can't blame him. Well, there is no point making all that money if you don't spend it. Nadal's garage includes a Ferrari 458 Italia, two Mercedes-Benzes, an Aston Martin DBS, the sleek car which made popular by James Bond film Casino Royale, and a Kia Stinger that cost more than all your food expenses in 10 years. These are 10 of the most expensive items that Rafael Nadal owns that cost more than your life. Informally known as the King of Clay, Nadal has 80 career single titles under his belt for a total of $7.7 million in prize winnings. He won the 2017 US Open, making an easy $3.7 million in prize money, as well as the 2018 French Open, earning $2.6 million and his 11th French Open title and 17th Grand Slam title. And added to all these are his numerous endorsements, which include a multi-million dollar deal with Nike. Nadal might have had to sweat in court to get where he has today, but now he really has nothing to worry about, especially when he cruises the streets in some hot wheels. The star reportedly owns some swanky vehicles, including the Mercedes-Benz SL55 and an Aston Martin DBS, both of which cost up to six figures. The SL55 starts at a $223,042 price tag. He won this car after winning the Mercedes Cup in Germany in 2015. This car can go up to speeds of 200 kilometers per hour within 16 seconds. Regardless of the fact that the star loves this car so much, it happens that this luxury might well be the cheapest in this video. Nadal just couldn't get enough adrenaline from the Mercedes. He swapped the Mercedes with another of his favorites, Aston Martin DBS. And the limited Aston Martin could definitely soothe his thirst for speed. The two-seater car, which can reach up to speeds of 100 kilometers per hour within 4 seconds, isn't just fast, but it also costs. Yes, the car which the star got when he was just 23 cost a whole of $517,000. This makes the Ferrari and the Kia Stinger in his garage look like a bonus. And yeah, this tennis star spends his money on even more luxurious assets, one of which is the six-figure Richard Mille watch. More specifically, this is a RM2704 Tour Billion Rafael Nadal. Due to his accomplishments in the tennis world and his long-term ambassadorship contract with the watchmaker, it would be fitting to design a watch whose face looks strikingly similar to a tennis racket. However, that is not the unique feature of this timepiece. The watch weighs just a fraction more than 1 ounce. That means you barely feel it when you are wearing it. And if you think nothing can beat the weightless $1 million wristwatch, then you'd be shocked at Nadal's estate assets. Rafael owns two dazzling residential properties, his house in Mallorca and another house in the Dominican Republic. He bought his magnificent home property at Mallorca for $4 million in the year 2003. This house for Nadal is his private sanctuary. Whenever the superstar isn't out trying to win the world with his swings, he stays in his luxurious house with his beautiful wife. Why wouldn't he? The player's house is spread over 1,000 square meters of land in Porto Cristo. Other buildings merged on this property cover an area of 7,000 square meters. And what is a star player's home without a gym? Rafael Nadal likes to hit the gym. This is the reason why a part of his house was transformed into a gym. This is the place where he spends his time when he is not playing his tournaments. Next in line in his house assets is the house in Playa Nueva Romana, Dominican Republic, worth $2 million. The villa has a beautiful view for the player to enjoy while on vacation. The swimming pool right in the front enhances the elegance of the house, along with the white-colored lounge chairs on the side of the pool and the sun right above your head. This is the favorite spot for the player to unwind. What's next? You see, Rafael knew he couldn't depend on commercial flights alone to take him across the world for his tournaments, and as well as business deals. The famous tennis player decided a private jet will do just fine for traveling. And he didn't just get any jet, he bought a Cessna Citation CJ2+, of which only 220 were produced and can cost up to $3,595,000. Not only is the purchasing price ridiculous, Nadal has to maintain it with $286,167 per year, just for maintenance. If you feel offended by the star's lavishing lifestyle, I believe the coming facts should soothe your soul. And where else to start than the 19th century building investment? Nadal has a gorgeous 19th century building in Madrid. According to reports, this $30 million property was bought with the thought of transformation into A-list residential properties. The property consists of 11 houses, out of which 9 have been sold already, with an estimated cost of between £15,000 and £20,000 per square meter. I might just bid for an acre of this land for you if you have subscribed. If you haven't, just click on that button real quick. Nadal is a man who loves his home, but he can't resist the adventure of the seas. While he has the wheels to make him fast and furious, he also spends his fortune on luxurious yachts. Rafael has previously owned a series of yachts, from his Princess V62 to his Italian-built MCY76 Beethoven, which he kept on sale in 2018 for $3 million. But while he might have sold his ex-baby, the player just wasn't comfortable anymore. He needed something, another baby on the sea to calm his soul. It didn't take long for him to decide what he wanted. By 2020, Nadal got his 80 Sunreef Power catamaran, which was custom made, and this yacht cost nothing less than $8.5 million. The yacht is powered by two 1,200 horsepower engines and has a personal jet ski garage, a 12-meter beam which is big enough to house a hot tub, a bar, and waterfall pod. The master suite offers sea views and also has an en-suite bathroom. With the four guest cabins, the yacht can accommodate 12 guests. You would hardly see any other tennis player with this. And if owning a major stake in real estate, a private jet, and yacht weren't enough, the mega-rich star also owns three tennis academies. You see, Nadal decided he didn't just want to be a legendary player remembered for his skills or luxurious life. He believed as a man he could be of influence in what other way than an open space for young talent in his field. Starting from Rafa Nadal Academy, which was established in the year 2016, located in Mallorca, Spanish Island, made on 24,000 square feet of land, is worth $25 million. The charge is fixed at 56,000 euros, which is 62,000 from children, for his tennis lessons. In the year 2019, he established another academy in Mexico, followed by Greece. Now, while 62,000 might be an exuberant fee for many, There are some who'd pay so much to get a little knowledge from the world number one player. Anyway, there is no doubt that this academy is a lucrative venture for the tennis star. Next is the recent Rafael Nadal Academy in Kuwait. An investment collaborated with Tamdine Group will consist of 8 outdoor and 8 indoor courts, a total of 18 courts, which will be opened with about 1,500 seats, which will cover an arena along with 5,000 seats. Kuwait is about to ride with luxury. The academy is one place to learn and grow. Nadal Sporting Centers are the real place to vent with talents. He opened the first Nadal Tennis Center in 2018. Located at the Grand Palladium Costa Mujeres Resort and Spa, Mexico. This center is open to guests who want to learn from famous world players. I guess Nadal understands the place of connection and motivation that he wanted to inspire people. A man isn't complete without a pint of virtue, and Rafael seems to have tons of that. And he doesn't hesitate to show this through his foundation, the Foundation Rafa Nadal, which focuses on sport and education for disadvantaged children. This foundation hasn't only helped children in sport, but people in general, especially during the lockdown in 2020. One shouldn't forget his donation of 1 million euros to an island affected by natural disaster. I am sure this act will forever be in the heart of many. And that's it for this video. Do not forget to subscribe and also like the video if you love what you see. And oh, don't forget to hit that notification button to get more videos that I post. Thank you.